When the power is switched on, the power supply from the battery and the battery charger is supplied to the electronic counting unit. The SSC1 card generates 21 kHz of 38 volt RMS AC voltage, which is fed into the transmitter coil TX1. And SSC2 card generates the 23 kHz of 38 volt RMS, which is fed into the transmitter coil TX2. The voltage in the receiver coil is produced due to the flux linkage between transmitter and receiver coil. In amplitude modulation type axle detector, the strength of the signal received in RX coil is approximately 750 to 1200 millivolt, which depends on the rail size. Receiver coil is produced due to the flux linkage between transmitter and receiver coil. In amplitude modulation type axle detector, the strength of the signal received in RX coil is approximately 750 to 1200 millivolt, which depends on the rail size. These signals are then fed back from RX1 and RX2 to card 1 and card 2 respectively. Then a wheel passes over the track device A. The following pulse is received at the MLB card. Similarly, when the wheel passes over track device B, the following pulse is received at card 4. An in count is registered now. Since the in count from modulation signal from track device A is received and processed before the modulation signal from track device B, the direction of the wheel movement is A to B, that is, in this direction. When the following sequence is complete, it is counted as one in. Because of this, the section is shown as occupied at both the units and the station master reset box. Similarly, when the train passes from the second detection point at the other end, that is track device D and track device C, the following pulses are generated in the evaluator. The out count is registered now. As the modulated signal from D is received by C, the direction of the movement of the wheel is registered as D to C, that is, in this direction. When the following sequence is complete, it is counted as one out count. When counts are balanced in entry end and exit end, vital relay picks up at both the ends. Now let us assume a trolley with 12 axles enters the section. At the entry end A and B, the in counts are registered 0 to 12. We have shown the in count increment in stages. During dynamic braking, the following circuits are reorganized. Number 1, the main power motor circuit. 2, the governor control engine speed circuit. And 3, the propulsion control circuit. These will now be discussed in details one by one. The current flow is as follows. The outdoor unit wiring connections, as per the recommended color code, is as follows. This is the terminal block. The connections of the terminal block with the main PCB of the outdoor unit is as following. 1. The neutral supply will go from terminal 1N through white wire at the connector CN7 of the main outdoor PCB. The ambient temperature sensor is connected at CN22 of the main outdoor PCB. The reactor is connected to the connector RO and R1 of SPDU through the red wire. This is the compressor. The U-terminal of the compressor is connected to the U-terminal of the SPDU through black wire. The V-terminal of the compressor is connected to the V-terminal of SPDU through white wire, and the W-terminal of the compressor is connected to the W-terminal of SPDU through red wire. This is the step-by-step flow in this circuit. Let us now take a look at the entire working of this circuit. In this section, we will explain the principle of working of the digital axle counter system with the help of three-dimensional computer modeling and animation. The system consists of two pairs of web-mounted TX and RX axle detectors fitted at each end of the section. One pair of location box that houses one SSDAC electronic unit. One vital relay box consisting of two relays. And one pair of surge voltage protection device. A pair of suitable battery charger with battery. And a pair of reset box kept in the station master's room. The SSDAC unit of the digital axle counter system is manufactured in a 3U high and 42T width desktop enclosure. The system comprises of 8 plug-in modules. All the cards are of extended single euro size, that is 220 mm into 100 mm, that plugs into a motherboard in the sub-rack. The main features of the signal conditioner card are carrier signal generation, demodulation, pulse shaper and pulse generation, phase reversal detection, that is for phase reversal type axle detector only, supervisory signals generation and detection. These cards show the following LED indications. This card shows the following LED indication. TX, green LED will flash to indicate the signal transmission information from the local unit. RX, the green LED will flash to indicate the signal receiving information from remote unit. Mode, the green LED is normally off. When the system is made off and on, the LED glows and again goes low when the system enters a self-test after successful reset. CD, the green LED will glow when the carrier is detected.